thank you for staying with us and talking, of course, further about surrogacy. Most couples prefer to have a surrogate mother who's had at least one child. Doctors claim that that is because their emotional attachment may be lesser. But can a mere contract really subvert maternal instinct? That's what we're about to find out in this segment. And first, let's have a look at a story of a surrogate mother.
मेरे अपना बच्चा मिसकैरेज हुआ, उसके बाद मुझे हुआ नहीं. ऐसे तो मैं ट्रीटमेंट के लिए आई, तो मुझे सरोगेट के बारे में पता चला. मैंने देखा कि मेरे को पैसे की कमी है, मैं कर नहीं पा रही हूँ IVF, इसीलिए फिर मैंने सरोगेट किया. और उसके बाद जो पेमेंट मिला उससे मैंने फिर अपने लिए IVF स्टार्ट किया. मेरे हस्बैंड, मैडम और कपल, हमारे अलावा और किसी को पता नहीं है और हम लोग नहीं चाहते कि किसी को बताए. मुझे तो 9 महीने तक ही लगा कि ये मेरा ही बच्चा है. मैंने वैसे ही रखा उनको. मेरी देते हुए थोड़ा ये हुआ, लेकिन उनका ही था वो. मैं मेंटली मुझे पता था.
There obviously a lot more that goes on than one is aware about when it comes to this process of surrogacy and being a surrogate mother for another person. We are joined now in the studio by Ritu. I'm deliberately hiding her real name. She's also wearing these clothes deliberately to conceal her identity for her own comfort. I want to make that just very clear. Ritu, yahan par aane ke liye aapka bahut bahut shukriya. Aapne is madhyam se ek bacche ko janm diya hai?
Ji.
To aapne jab janm diya to aapko lagav laga bacche se?
हाँ, थोड़ा बहुत. तो
कितना कठिन था आपके लिए उस बच्चे को जाने देना?
मैंने देखा ही नहीं, मतलब पहले ही बोल दिया था कि मुझे देखना नहीं है. तो डिलीवरी के बाद मैंने देखा ही नहीं बच्चों को,
बिल्कुल भी नहीं देखा.
जी नहीं.
आपका अपना भी बच्चा है?
जी.
तो क्या जब लोग कहते हैं कि अगर आपका अपना बच्चा हो तो दूसरे बच्चे को देना थोड़ा आसान हो जाता है, क्या आपको लगता है कि वो उसमें कोई सच्चाई है?
मुझे तो ऐसा नहीं लगता.
आपने सरोगेट मदर होने का फैसला कैसे लिया?
मैंने अपने हस्बैंड से बात की कि मैं ऐसा करूं, तो उन्होंने बोला तुम्हारी मर्जी है. तो फिर मैंने सोचा कि मतलब मुझे फाइनेंशियली भी हेल्प हो जाएगी और किसी और को भी हेल्प मिलेगी ना.
तो आप घर में ही थी जब प्रेग्नेंट थी कि कहीं और जाकर?
नहीं नहीं, मैं अपने घर में ही थी.
तो वहाँ पर आस पड़ोस के लोग भी होंगे?
जी.
तो फिर उन्हें आपने बता दिया कि मैंने ये किया है?
जी नहीं.
क्यों नहीं बताया?
काफ़ी लोग नहीं समझ पाते. काफ़ी लोग ये सोचते हैं कि अरे ये सब गलत है, सरोगेट मतलब शायद ये कोई गलत काम है.
तो फिर आपने कैसे समझाया लोगों को कि 9 महीने तक बच्चा था, अब कहाँ गया?
तो मैंने बोल दिया ये कि मेरा मिसकैरेज हो गया.
Why is a woman who is willingly happily providing her womb for a good cause, why does she have to hide her face?
Such a social stigma. Even today there are so many people who are not accepting adoption because of the social stigma.
Huge drive that in patriarchal societies that we have, that you think that your lineage can only pass if it's your own, of your own blood. Because there is that preoccupation of your own blood and the concern that any tapering around with that would create problems, you would keep looking for technological fixes to deal with it. But the fact remains, in what ways do we want women's bodies to be used? I would want to finish this. In what ways do we want women's bodies to be used? And what is this preoccupation? Mandira, what is this preoccupation that women should be responsible for their families to fetch their homes, to take care of education, children?
They are doing this, they are volunteering to be a surrogate mother.
Yeah, yeah. Lots of women volunteer for many.
How many surrogate mothers, Amit, have you protected?
If the surrogate has a problem, they come to me because it's a bilateral contract and I'm being a lawyer for the both the parties. I have to take care of
who
the
pays,
interest of
who
both.
Who pays the bills?
The bills are paid by the
couples. The bills are paid by the couples.
And so the money to the surrogate goes through the clinic
so
and the couples.
So in face of a dispute, is it correct to say that your loyalties would lie with the couple considering they're the ones of
contract? No, not really. I'm bound by the code of ethics. I have seen a case where the couple landed up paying twice the money which was agreed, and on the sheer blackmail.
Blackmail, this happens.
Sheer blackmail has
which
happened, and it is not the,
IPs
that is the intended parents who have exploited, but it is the other way around.
Contracts are written, taking that one outlier in perspective.
Madam, every case
that
is
one
rare first.
Outlier becomes the basis for a lot of contracting. As a result, the lawyers actually work on behalf of the couples, not on behalf of the surrogate.
Surrogate mothers, you choose to have the babies of the parents who come to you. are all housed in your clinic and cut off from their families?
Not really. Not really. There are so many of them, about 20% who would stay with their families.
So there's no diktat from
there
you to say
no
you can't
There is no diktat that they have to 100%. We try to keep them in
there. But why?
This is the reason, because of the hygiene, the food they eat, their health. But most of the surrogates willingly want to stay in the surrogate house.
One, see, on the one hand, there's a kind of attempt to say that let's not define it as an industry.
Yeah.
But all the examples that come very clearly tell you that this is part of a global care economy. I'm saying, as a social scientist, as a person who represents the civil society, as a person who looks into the larger ethical frameworks that determine our lives, we need to look at all these concerns, because what we are basically doing is we are giving a very independent citizen status to an embryo. That you, what happens to the birthing mother and her right is somewhere being completely eliminated because the legal framework is not
mother,
very clear.
Both mother's name has to go on the paper until we have the law.
Yeah,
we do not have the law. We have formed in the guidelines, but it has not formed the legislation. Today, if we put gestational mother's name on the baby, it's wrong.
That India does not have any stringent rules or laws to govern surrogacy or assisted reproductive technology. How big a part does that have to play?
It's like a
in the fact that India is a destination.
It's like a double-edged sword. So many of them are worried that there are no laws. What will happen if the baby delivers?
There is one another reason for which the NRI come more often to India. Is probably they feel that, as he said, that blackmailing each other. That may not be so much possible in India.
And if you look at the way the tourist industry promotes this, along with the exotic India, you are promoting a number of things, you know. So I would say be much more, if that is the way it is going to be, let's be much more upfront about it. Let's have a large commission that looks at what are the rights of these women, like the workers' rights, and how do you actually protect that?
There is, you know, there's a spectrum here. It's a very, very wide, very, very wide, vast topic. I don't think we, as much as we try, I don't think we can wrap it all up here. There's a need for regulation, there's a need for lawyers, there's a need for proper guidelines, there's a need for a lot of things, there's a need for transparency to an extent. So a lot of things that are still to be put in place, and there's a long, long way to go for that. But again, one thing is for sure, that surrogacy is very much here in India and here to stay. And whether we like it or we don't, India is most certainly a destination for couples who are looking for surrogate mothers for their babies. Thank you very much for joining us in this episode of The Baby. Sri Lanka are yet to win a test series here in India, and if they do so this time, they'll have broken a 27-year-old jinx. Now, the man who's the captain of the ship this time round is Kumar Sangakkara. Sanga, your thoughts going into the series? A lot of pressure.
Well, not really on us. See, we've 27 years, we haven't won even one test match, so the pressure is really on the Indians to stop us from doing that. So we're here to enjoy ourselves, you know, stay under the radar, do our work, you know, train hard and go and perform well in games. So hopefully we'll go well.
You said the pressure's on the Indians. Do you think they're capable of defending that well?
Oh, they are, you know, a fantastic side. They've always been in all formats of the game. You know, we beat them last time they were in Sri Lanka, and we'd like to carry that form here. But every test match is a new one, and they're, you know, they've just lost to the Australians, so they'll be willing, wanting to come back really hard.
Now, what's different for you this time is this is your first test match here as a captain.
Yeah, you know, it's nice. It's been a good 4 months for us. A lot of ups, a few downs, but I think all in all, a pretty solid start. So hopefully we can continue that here.
About you personally, Sang, everybody goes through their ups and downs. You went through your down some time ago, but now touch with things are back on a roll and on a high. What did you do?
Well, you know, my form's always been very consistent. I train quite hard. I make sure that I cover all my bases at training. And because of that, you know, the runs have kept coming for the last 4 or 5 years, so I'm pretty happy with where I am. Still a long way to go, hopefully, you know, in my test and ODI careers, but pretty happy with the way I'm playing.
Are you enjoying being captain?
Yeah, it's been a revelation. It's been quite an interesting time. You know, my philosophy is simple. You know, do the right thing at all times, train hard, play hard, and the rest will take care of itself. At the end of the day, you have to be responsible and accountable.
Okay, now let's talk about your team for a minute. Not many of them have toured India before. Is that a concern at all?
Sometimes, but I think more than that, you know, a fresh perspective would be great for the guys to have. New guys coming in want to impress and want to do well, so the enthusiasm rubs off on the rest of the field. And that kind of, you know, boyish enthusiasm is great to have in the dressing room. So hopefully they'll go out there. They won't care about what's gone before, what's you know really going to happen, but they'll concentrate on the moment and doing well there.
Look ahead to this series now. What are the hurdles in front of you? You've seen the way India has placed against Australia. So what are your thoughts going into the series?
Oh, that's a pass because we think because it doesn't count at all because a new series and it's going to be a test series and it's challenging for us and we want to play well because we never won a test match in India. So that's an achievement we ought to achieve here. And if we win the series, we'll be number one side in the world. So that's a big achievement for us, a small country like Sri Lanka, to achieve that. So great challenges in forward. So we're looking forward for it.
Absolutely. That'll be the 27-year-old jinx that you'll be hopefully breaking if things go your way. Now, speaking about Ajanta Mendis for just a minute, what is the advice that you give to him as a mentor?
It's very difficult to give him advice because he's a different type of bowler and I'm a different type of bowler because he's doing well at the moment and I don't want to confuse him or anything. Just leave him alone and say what he's doing at the best and do the best because rather than just confuse him and then things can get complicated.
What's the message you'd like to give Sachin on this all-important 20 years? And considering that the first test match starts the day after his 20 years get over.
First time I played against Sachin is in India, especially because of a one-day game. Before that, I heard about his name and matches I've been not seen because in TV. And soon as I saw, he was about 17 years, 18 years or something at the time. So when he walked into bat and he was batting at number 6, number 7 position in a one-day cricket, the way he played, I thought it's something special. So on that day at one, I think he's a special player and he has been living up to his mark and he's doing everything right at the moment and everything goes right for him as well because getting about 17,000 one-day runs and about 13,000 test runs not easy to take.